bringing you the news and information you need from the people making a difference. This is Comcast Newsmakers.
Hi, welcome to Comcast Newsmakers. I'm Sabrina Register. We are here at the Governor's Mansion for a reception honoring Olympic athletes from Washington. And I'm joined right now by Christian Nickum from Woodinville, Washington, Olympian. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
It's great to be able to talk to all the athletes and congratulate you on making it to the Olympics. This, in fact, is your second Olympics. This Olympics, what do you take away from it? What was the best experience that you had?
Oh, the best experience. There's so many experiences. I think the biggest thing is just, you know, before it all, I had a dream of going to the Olympics. And then I set a goal to make that Olympics. And hopefully, I was trying to win the gold. But to follow through, to at least make the Olympic team and have a shot at that gold medal, that's the best experience. And then after it all happened, to have my family, my daughter at the finish line and be able to give them a hug and kiss. And say, hey, we made it. You know, that's the best part.
Your sport that you excel in is not for the faint of heart. You are whipping down that luge track, say the fastest track in the world. After the tragic death of the athlete from Georgia, was there ever a moment where you paused and perhaps were a little concerned?
For me, not at all. I'm very focused. When I go down that luge track, a lot of training, a lot of preparation goes into it. This is my 20th year in the sport. That being said, watching other people do it, it is scary. It is scary. My mom, she has a hard time. She can't even watch me go down. But that's kind of concerning to me because I tell her, hey, I know what I'm doing. You can trust me. I train very hard at this, and I'm very focused in what I'm doing. And after 20 years of doing it, I've only had one hospital stay, so.
So you didn't have to change your approach at all after the fatal accident?
Well, I did. Unfortunately, they changed the starting point on the track. They lowered it, which made it totally changed the race. For the past year, all of our training runs and training has been from a different start. When they changed that start, it really changed the track. Luge is a sport that's measured to the thousands of a second, so you have to be very precise with all your steers and movements on the way down. And I was set for a different start. So when they changed the start, I only had 6 runs to learn that start instead of I already had 40 runs at the other start. So it was challenging to make the quick switch. And I wish, even now I kind of replay it, you know, that start. I wish I had some more runs because I think I could have done a little bit better with a couple more runs. But it was all even. Everyone had the same amount of runs and the best won.
After the Olympics are over, you've trained so hard for so long. Is it kind of like when you're a kid and you look forward to your birthday and your birthday party for months and months, and then it's gone like that? Is it sort of that deflated feeling like, oh, it's over?
No, I wouldn't call it like that. My brother, after the race, we went out to eat, our whole family, my whole family fan club. We're all there, we're going out to eat. And my oldest brother kind of pulled me aside and was like, it's got to be a relief, huh? I'm like, yeah, I would say that's the biggest feeling is a relief. Got a little bit of remorse. You know, you wish would have had that medal, but I gave it my all, you know. Day in, day out, I gave it everything that I had. And the end result, that's racing. You know, that's life. You don't always win, but you can win personally by giving it everything that you have. So it was a relief that I made it to that point, day in, day out, giving it everything that I had.
Another Olympics in your future?
We'll have to see. My daughter's 20 months right now, and luge is still a sport. It's 100% amateur for me. It's not a job. It's something that I'm doing for the love of the sport, and I do love it. It's awesome. It's so much fun racing down the track at 90 miles per hour. But family has to come first. There's nothing more important than life. There's no gold medal greater than having a family and especially having a daughter.
Olympian Christian Nickum, so nice to talk to you. Congratulations on making it to the Olympics. So nice to meet you.
Thanks.
And thanks for watching Comcast Newsmakers. Headline news at the top of the hour.